The Garibaldi Panorama is a very unique artifact because very few of these survive from the 19th century. It's a very large piece of work. It's over 273 feet long. It's painted on both sides in watercolor.
Peter Harrington, who's the curator of the John Hay, called me up and said, you should come and see what we have here.
And it was a bit overwhelming at the time. I thought, well, what can we do with this? One idea behind digitizing it was to preserve it, but also to make it known to a much wider audience.
When the library scanned this, it was actually scanned in about 40 or 50 individual blocks. And then the application stitches those together into a whole. So as you scroll through, it looks like one solid piece of artwork.
And of course, the website doesn't do justice to the scale of this thing. You see this on a 12-inch by 15-inch screen, and you see it passing through.
So then what was the next step? The next step was to put it on the Microsoft Surface so that you could touch that physical object, but in a virtual way.
You can actually look at the Surface at a basic level. It's almost being an oversized iPhone, except for it's more than that because it uses vision technology, so you don't actually have to touch the Surface in order to interact with it.
One can actually look at the Garibaldi Panorama, move it around, touch the screen on certain panels, and see related material.
And that's really the meaning of research, and it's also the meaning of how you teach and how you learn. You take parts of existing documents, you recombine them, and you think about new meanings for them.
The possibility of zooming into these specific details and linking them to some of the documents, the documentation that we are collecting and gathering, it's extremely valuable.
This is a wonderful example of something that was never possible in the past, an item of great historical significance that almost never got used because it was essentially unusable because of its format, that now is opening up exciting possibilities.
You can do things differently, you can think differently, you can create differently if you have a different form factor.
It's become a fascinating interdisciplinary project which does not involve only the panorama as an art object but a sort of a hybrid media.
So in many ways the library becomes a place for publication, kind of public consumption of the materials. And I think that the Garibaldi project demonstrates how the library is able to do that.